Symbolism, the abuna presents floral crosses. The spiritual dances and songs of the priests provide the setting for this festive ceremony.
Shalom, Rastafari. Okay, this is my way of, I guess, interpreting Revelation chapter 4. And so, being that Wyndham Yadon has been speaking on related matters, I thought it'd be okay to share this image and kind of explain what's going on. Not that it's 100% accurate or anything, but it's an idea. Now, we'll begin chapter 4. After this I looked, and behold, a door was opened in heaven, and the first voice which I heard was as it were a trumpet talking with me, which said, "Come up higher, come up hither, and I will shew thee things which must be hereafter." Now, door opening in heaven. Prior to the 1800s, maybe the 1600s, was the first penetration into Ethiopia. Well, one of the most successful, but kind of around the 1800s, mid-1800s, it's when there was like the door of Ethiopia was opened. Like, there was a lot more traffic going in and out, and so technology allowed for easier travel. And so now Ethiopia became known to the majority of civilization, to a large part of civilization. And so that could be represented as that door opening in heaven. You know, Jah finally let man, I guess, well, beast, penetrate that natural barrier. Now, trumpet, well, coincidentally enough, you know, every time there's like a video on His Imperial Majesty, Kedamawi Haile Selassie, you always hear trumpets, right? I mean, not that that's something really important, but something to note. Now, these are things that are to come hereafter. So, obviously, it wasn't then, and it's representing this vision of John is representing this modern time. Now, verse 2. "And immediately I was in the spirit, and behold, a throne was set in heaven, and one sat on the throne." Throne of King David, descendant, Haile Selassie, was crowned and fulfilling that part. Now, "And he that sat was to look upon like a jasper and a sardine stone. And there was a rainbow round about the throne, in sight like to an emerald." Now, jasper is kind of yellow, sardine is red, but you could also get like crystal clear stone out of these. You could get many colors out of these stones, not including the emerald. The emerald is the green. Now, jasper and the sardine, you can mess around with it. I don't really know how they get different colors, but anyways, you get these colors, and if you want to add the different kinds of shades of color you can get out of those stones, out of jasper and sardine, then it could just very well mean, you know, the rainbow colors. Out of those seven colors, you get pretty much everything else. And so, regardless, it's significant. It relates to, you know, the colors of ionized standard. And so, let us continue. Now, and round about the throne were 24 seats. And upon the seats I saw 24 elders sitting, clothed in white raiment. And they had on their heads gold, crowns of gold. I'll be honest, when I did this, I only included 12 elders. I really did not want to go into detail and you know, draw the 24 of them. At first I did, but then I kind of backed down. I apologize, you know. And as far as the seats, honestly, I didn't even consider that. The crowns of gold, my way of thinking was so limited that all I could think about is big crowns. But then when I saw the video, Haile Selassie, Easter in Ethiopia, or you could check it out on the tubes. They do this, and it's a fasica practice, and they have slim little gold crowns, like if they were just a string. And if I would have thought about that at that time, I would have included them. And so white raiment, Ethiopian official, well, imperial Ethiopian, holy Ethiopian official raiment. Now, and out of the throne proceeded lightning and thundering and voices, and there were seven lamps of fire burning before the throne, which are the seven spirits of God. Now, I included, well, you know, the Sistra, which is directly connected to Egypt, and which make kind of like a brimstone sound, like, I guess you could say lightning, and then the drums can represent thunder, and I guess I and my brethren and sister can relate to Nyabingi drumming, and, you know, voicing, and harmonic patterns of voice, and then the you know, the drum having those three distinct sounds, which can represent what is being described here. So just how I decided to represent it. Actually, if you go to YouTube's, I'll put a clip of the video, so because all of this plays out in motion, you know. And so I'll do my best to add that video clip, and then you're gonna see white raiment, you're gonna hear the thunders, and you're gonna hear the sistras rattling, and they're all gonna bow down when the emperor is to appear. The emperor will be sitting on the throne of David, and that was set up in heaven. One Haile Selassie, one Kedamawi sat upon the throne. Now, let us continue before I get off track. I'm going to continue from verse 5. And out of the throne proceeded lightnings and thunderings and voices. Oh, interesting to note also, like in Christmas Lutheran special, it's like Oswald, he makes sure to kind of include, you could even hear thundering once or twice because it was a rainy day or something. I just thought it's interesting how if you check out all the videos on His Imperial Majesty, the people narrating the videos, they say a lot of things that are bearing witness to the truth. It's just that you gotta pay attention. And I find that to be quite interesting because, you know, they'll say stuff like, he's practically the incarnation of the history of our time. That's you know, if you understand clearly what he's saying, you know, you'll know it's like a direct it's testifying, kind of like like when he visits Jamaica and everyone was anxious, you know, something to that effect, or looking up into the clouds, waiting for the silver bird to appear. You know, it kind of reminds I of how he, the dove and the, well, let us not go into that because I'm already going off track. Okay, so, and before the throne, there was a sea of glass, like to crystal. And in the midst, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't even point out the seven spirits of God, which were the seven lamps. They're these ones right here. Now, I actually did want to represent kind of like the candle, the lampstand. I don't know if you can kind of get this, how if you just kind of twist these lines or bend them a little. I wanted to get that effect, but I forgot last minute. I honestly forgot that I wanted to include that. But I did include these seven figures, well, circular figures that are to represent. Well, I wanted them to represent the seven lampstands. Now, and round about the throne were four beasts full of eyes before and behind. Now, the sea of glass, the reason I put record and like the charging battery and time and SP is because I just wanted to, like if it was a TV screen, you know, the sea of glass like onto crystal, I just thought it'd be interesting to include, like, if this was being filmed, and the fact that this was round, kind of like when you get that before in the old school TVs, you would get that effect. Now, anyone that's not Rastafari, take in consideration that if I've seen a lot of different representations of these happenings, these facts. Now, I've seen some, you know, I don't want to say what denominations or whatever, but you're gonna get images like a lion with, you know, sitting on a throne and a crown, like a literal lion, and then you're gonna get beast with wings, like, I don't know, you're gonna get all kinds of like, and then there's gonna actually be an ocean, like crystal clear. I prefer not to accept that for obvious reasons, so I thought I'd describe the sea of crystal or clear sea with as it representing the TV screen. So, because he was in the moment, he was in the spirit. Johannes was in now. He was in the spirit of the now. Now, the four beasts, full of eyes, before and behind. The four beasts I represented as the constellations, and the eyes before, and it's the stars, because, you know, there's stars before and behind, and so I don't know if you could clearly see, but the constellations are actually drawn out, and then there's the representation of scripture, of revelation, above to kind of to more clearly, this is Aquarius, Aquila, and then Taurus, Taurus, Leo. Now, let us continue. And the first beast was like a lion, right here. And the second beast, like a calf, Taurus. Ross Adonis mentioned this. That's the reason I'm kind of sharing this with the eyes now. And the third beast had the face as a man. I chose Aquarius. I didn't know a whole lot about this. Sagittarius, I think it's the horse, the body of a horse with the man with the bow. I didn't use that one because I remembered Mark chapter 14 verse 13 and Lucas chapter 22 verse 10. Let's really quickly go to Mark chapter 14, verse 13. And he sendeth forth two of his disciples and said to them, go ye into the city, and there shall meet you a man bearing a pitcher of water. Follow him. And then if we go to Luke. Yeah, Lucas Wengale. Good news of chapter 22, verse 10. Now it reads, "And he said to them, Behold, when ye are entered into the city, there shall a man meet you, bearing a pitcher of water. Follow him into the house where he enters them." Now, that's the reason I chose Aquarius. And later I found out that it was good. Well, I knew from the beginning, I guess, but I had to kind of be sure of it, have evidence to back it up. You know what Ras Sayadaunus, Wendam Yaden, is constantly telling us. You know, we forget sometimes, but... So, let's try not to. Now. And the fourth beast was like a flying eagle. So, obviously, Aquila. Let's continue. I lost my place. Give me 1 second. And the four beasts had each of them 6 wings about him. And they were full of eyes within. And the rest... I apologize. And they rest not day and night, saying, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. I guess it'd be like, Kiddush, Kiddush, Kiddush. No, it is actually Kiddush, Kiddush, Kiddush. And... which was and is to come. Okay, well, the eyes within, the stars, the 6 wings. A lot of people describe each beast with 6 wings, but I knew for a fact that it had to do with the geometry and other related aspects of the teaching. So 6 wings about it, like, let me read that again so I could better describe it. And the 4 beasts had each of them 6 wings about him. About him. I kind of went into that and I concluded, maybe just a favor I'm on, but I decided that about isn't like exactly that each one of them had 6 wings, but it just ended up... let me first say that they don't necessarily have to be winged flying wings. You see, if you could kind of think, if you can imagine that this is kind of like in the back, this is a cube, right? And I guess I'm trying to depict like depth and volume. And I'm sure you've heard before, like the left wing and the southern wing and the east wing of like a building. Well, it doesn't have to mean like flying wings. It could be sections. And so by establishing the seven spirits, the 7 flames, you automatically get what is the cross, which is the cube, indicative of that. Well, here's the cube. No, my bad. Cube, if you can see that. I did it all over the place, but... And then which is inevitably that same circle. And, well, the 7 lamps just automatically place the wings, right? And so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 sections divided by the wings. So that's what how I interpreted the 6 wings. About, you know, about here's and then about, I guess. If that even makes sense. Well, let I continue. Oh, and they rested not day and night. Well, we have, like, we get night and then we get day, but the stars don't. So they do not rest. You know, one side of the world is it's nighttime, the other is daytime. But the stars are always there, always shining, always trying to point us to the right direction. Well, And so that represents that right there. The one which was and is to come, obviously, at this point in time, accept it or not, it's Kedamawi, Haile Shlase, Igushin, I guess. So, you know, Rastafari, Rastafari, Haile Selassie. If you have a problem with that, I don't know what to say. It's pretty obvious. It really is. You know, if you have nothing to do with Rastafari and you're viewing this, it's not that hard, you know? Like, just what it is. Well, the 24 elders fall down before him that sat on the throne and worship him that liveth forever and ever and cast their crowns before the throne, saying, Thou art worthy, O Lord, O Adonai, to receive Kabbalah, glory. You know, glory, I don't know, I can't recall if how it's used in this case, but glory doesn't necessarily all the time mean the same thing. Sometimes it represents a Hebraic word that glory is like vision, kind of like to glorify, to make known, to make appear, to make that it's seen. So, because at least I used to always have this idea of glory, like kind of like splendor and majesty, you know, like, you know, gold. You get this idea. Well, it could also mean just like to make known, to make apparent and cause for all to see and to view. Now, a lot of these words within the chapter you can play around with. That's why I want to say that it's just how I decided to represent it. It's up to each of the eyes to find out what they get out of it. Not that there's different meanings, right? But you know, jowling together, we can cancel out the parts that don't fit and come to the complete truth. Now, as I mentioned, look up YouTube. Oh, I'm gonna add the clip, but as soon as the emperor is as soon as it's declared that the emperor is to step out, all in white raiment, they bow to him that sat on the throne. Jawulin will, I'll get that in this video. Now, Thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power. For Thou hast created all things, and for Thy pleasure they are and were created. So this ends chapter 4 of Revelation. Hopefully, I did an okay job to kind of explain this image, and hopefully it's kind of accurate. And so I just thought with all that talk that our brother in the line of Judah society has been dealing with, I thought I'd just share this. I guess I'll just add, created all things, and for Thy pleasure they are and were created. Before His Imperial Majesty, none existed. Everything was non-existent, I guess, if that even makes sense. But to Aiman, His Imperial Majesty is the creator of heavens and the earth. Because before him, I had no idea of such things. So to I, he did create heavens and earth. I'm not sure I explained that well, but so, well, let I and I conclude. Shalom, brothers and sisters, and Glory be to His Imperial Majesty.
Early in the morning on Easter Saturday, the gardens of the Imperial Palace provide the setting for a solemn procession of priests and deacons. Richly jeweled processional crowns and gaily coloured umbrellas accompany the bundle of sticks, which are reminders of the scourging of Christ. The ribbons worn on the forehead symbolise the crown of thorns. On the palace steps, members of the government and the court await the appearance of the emperor. Which is traditionally performed on Easter Saturday, is an expression of the church's joy as Christ descends into hell to triumph over evil for the redemption of the world. Mm-hmm.